Hello everyone, I am Nikhil Kumar. Welcome back to the GitHub Actions series. Today we are diving into something that can save your hours of build time in your CI/CD workflow. That is catching dependencies for faster build. If you're tired of waiting for your builds to install the same dependencies over and over again, this video is for you. Let me show you how catching works, why it matters, and how you can easily implement it in your GitHub Actions workflow. Dependency caching is like shortcut for your builds. Instead of downloading dependencies every time your workflow runs, we can save them in a cache. On the subsequent run, your workflow pull from these cache instead of downloading them again. Without caching, workflow downloads dependencies every time. But with caching, workflow pulls dependencies from the cache. Not only does this save time, but it also reduces network usage and speed up your development cycle. Let's jump into the practical part. I will demonstrate this with a Python project. But the process is similar for other languages like Node.js, Java, or Go. I've already created a couple of Python files which is required to demonstrate this particular demo. So I have created one Python file that is app.py, which is doing the printing of the statement and adding two numbers. Along with that, I have also added one requirements.txt file, which is just having a PyTest package to install on the top of runner machine. And I have also one PyTest file, which will be running when we are executing the workflow to test the code. And this is my workflow file, that is pythonapp.yml. This is the Python CI file. It will be running on the push event, which is happening on the main branch, and it always runs on the Ubuntu-latest runner. First step is to check out the code, and second is to set up the Python version, that is 3.9, and then it will install the dependencies by upgrading the pip, and then it will reinstall the dependencies which is mentioned in the requirement.txt, that is a PyTest, and then it will run the PyTest. So let's modify our file, that is app.py, and let's see how it works. So I committed the changes, and if we go back here and click on the Python CI again, so it got triggered, and let's see. So if you see, it's installing the dependency. It installed the dependencies and then it ran the PyTest and then it cleaned up the job. So if you notice, it takes some time to install the dependencies. So it's for each and every run, it downloads the dependencies from the scratch. This wastes the time. So let's add caching to speed this up. GitHub provides built-in actions, that is cached action, to store and retrieve the files like a dependency package. So for that, let me go back to our workflow file, that is our Python app.yml, and let's add a block over there to create a cache. Before installing the dependencies, let me set a cache pip dependency. So I'm defining one step, that is cache pip dependencies, and I'm going to use a action, that is a cache uses actions cache at v3. Basically, this line is telling GitHub action to use official action, that is cache action. This action is like a smart storage manager for your workflow. It helps us to store files between runs and then fetch them back when needed to speed up things. In this case, we are caching Python dependencies. Next, let's specify the path. So I'm going to use a with, and inside that I'm going to define the path, and I'm defining a path that is dot cache slash pip. This is the directory where pip stores downloaded package file and dependencies. By caching the pip cache folder, we make sure we don't have to download the same dependencies every time our workflow runs. The next time our workflow runs, if the dependencies haven't changed, GitHub action will just use the cache version. So let me add a key here. Basically, the key is what makes this cache unique. It's like a fingerprint for your cache. The key is here is to made up of runner.os. So let me define that first. Runner.os. This ensures the cache is specified to the operating system we are using. In our case, we are going with Ubuntu, so that is unique for the Linux system. If we are going with the Windows or macOS, so that will be unique for that particular operating system. Then I am going to specify the pip. It's just a label to indicate this cache is related to the Python dependencies. Then I'm going to specify the hash file and the requirement.txt file. So let me define that first, and hash files and the asterisk and the requirements dot txt, curly braces closed. This part is the most important. It generates the hash of your requirement.txt file. So if your dependencies change, a new cache is created automatically. So this way your cache stay up to date with the Python dependencies. And at last, we need to define the restore keys and the pipe symbol. So we have a restore keys. These keys are act as a fallback option. If the cache with the exact key does not exist, maybe like because the dependency in the requirement.txt changed, then the GitHub action will try to find a previous cache using the broader key. Here in our case, let me use the runner OS. So runner.os and hyphen pip. Because why we use the runner.os? So basically it will only look for the operating system, so it can still restore the cache from the earlier run that have the same OS. By caching the pip dependencies, we save a lot of time in subsequent workflow run. For example, if we have already installed the dependency in one run, the next time the workflow run, it can simply use the cache dependency instead of downloading them again. This means faster, more efficient build and less waiting around. And that's the power of caching. Now I will push the changes and let's see how it performs. So I committed the changes. And if we go back here and just refresh this page, if you see now it has one task that is cache pip dependencies. So it shows that cache not found for input key. That means there is no cache already present in that particular system. So it's going with the new cache. After the run, if you see, it's creating a cache dependencies. So if you see cache saved successfully and cache saved with key, this is the one. Because we are using the runner.os, so it's saving a cache with the Linux operating system, because our runner is a Ubuntu based. So if the next time if I run this particular run, so it will not download it again. It will just use it from the cache. So it will take some time to create a cache memory over there. So it created a cache dependency successfully, if you see, and it also cleaned up the job as well. So let's try to rerun the job again. But let's push some changes to the main branch. So I'm modifying the same file, that is app.py. And I'm just adding comment that is test. It triggered the new job. So if you notice, it quickly moved to the next subsequent steps. So, and if we open the install dependencies, you can see it used the cache. So it's using the cache and it's not installing the any dependencies. So that's the power of the dependency cached. So now let's simulate a cache miss by updating the requirement.txt file. So let's modify the requirement.txt file, and I'm going to update one package in this setup tools. And let's push the changes. So now we have added one more package to the requirement.txt, and let's see how it performs now. And if you notice, this time it will try to install the packages. And if you see, now it's again creating a cache of the dependencies, because we have added one more package in the requirement.txt file, that is setup tools. So after updating, the hash will change and the GitHub will create a new cache. And that's how you can use caching to speed up your builds. Not only does this save time, but it also optimizes your CI/CD pipeline for efficiencies. Remember, caching is especially useful for projects with large dependencies or frequent builds. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel for upcoming videos on the GitHub Actions series, and let me know in the comment what topic you would like me to cover next. See you in the next video.